Hello dear children, let's start where we left in video 4, Madam Rides the Bus. Now Wali reached at city, but she did not get down from the bus. Her emotions are extremely in her control. The conductor, "Hey lady," said the conductor, "aren't you ready to get off? This is as far as your 30 paisa takes you." The conductor said, "Lady, now you should get down because your 30 paisa could take you to this place only." "No," Wali said, "I'm going back on this same bus." She took another 30 paisa from her pocket and handed the coins to the conductor. She said, "No, I'm going to go back with the same bus, and this is my fare of 30 paisa." She handed over those 30 paisa coins to the conductor. "Why is something the matter?" "No, nothing the matter. I just felt like having the bus ride, that's all." Now the conductor could not believe in it because everybody is coming to city to see, to wash, to purchase something or for some work. So he said, "What is the matter?" She said, "No, I just wanted to have the bus ride, that's why I came." "And no matter. Don't you want to have a look at the sights now that you are here all by myself?" "Oh, I would be much too afraid." Greatly amused by the girl's way of speaking, the conductor said, "But you were not afraid to come in the bus." "Nothing to be afraid of about that," she answered. "Well, then why not go to the stall over there and have something to drink?" "Nothing to be afraid of about that either." "Oh no, I couldn't do that." "Well, then let me bring you a cold drink." The conductor prompted her to go and enjoy. "You can see something, you may get down." But Wali said, "No, I am afraid." So he said, "When you are not afraid to come in the bus alone, then why are you afraid for that? Have something to drink." When she denied, he said, "I can bring something for you to drink." "No, I don't have enough money. Just give me my ticket, that's all. It will be my treat and not cost you anything." "No, no," she said firmly, "please no." The conductor shrugged and they waited until it was time for the bus to begin the return journey. Again, there were not many passengers. The conductor offered, when she said she did not have money to purchase anything, she had only 60 paisas. So the conductor said, "I can bring something for you to drink." At this also, Wali denied. And now conductor said, "Okay." He just shrugged his shoulder. And when return journey started, again, very less passengers were there. "Won't your mother be looking for you?" the conductor asked when he gave the girl her ticket. The conductor asked the girl that, "Won't your mother be looking for you, that you have come here?" "No, no, no one will be looking for me," she said. The bus started and again there were the same wonderful sights. She said, "No, nobody is looking for me." And the bus started, the wonderful sights started coming up in front of her. Wali was not bored in the slightest and greeted everything with the same excitement she would felt the first time. But suddenly she saw a young cow lying dead by the roadside, just where it had been stuck by some fast-moving vehicle. When Wali started her return journey, she was as excited as she was earlier while coming back. But the moment she noticed the dead body of the cow, which was stuck by a fast-moving vehicle, "Isn't that the same cow that ran in front of the bus of our trip of town to town?" she asked the conductor. At this, she asked the conductor, "Isn't it the same cow which was coming in front of our bus?" The conductor nodded, meaning he said, "Yeah." And she was overcome with sadness, and she became very sad to see the dead body of the cow. What had been a lovable, beautiful creature just a while ago had now suddenly lost its charm and its life and looked so horrible, so frightening as it lay there. Legs spread, dead, a fixed stare in its lifeless eyes, blood all over. The beautiful, life full of energetic cow, which was so pretty and excited some minutes before, now she was lying dead. earlier she was looking so beautiful and energetic. Now she had lost all her charms and she was looking so lifeless, so horrible. Okay, then now she was unable to understand why it is so. The bus moved on. The memory of the dead cow haunted her, dampening her enthusiasm. She no longer wanted to look out the window. Now, because of the memory of the cow, she lost all her enthusiasm to see, and she had become so lost in all the activities which was going now. She sat thus glued to her seat until the bus reached her village at 3:40. She stood up and stretched herself. When the bus reached at 3:30, she came down from the bus, and now this time she was looking so distressed, so stressed. Then she turned to the conductor and said, "Well, sir, I hope to see you again." Then she looked towards the conductor and she said, "Goodbye, we will meet again." "Okay, madam," he answered her, smiling. "Whenever you feel like a bus ride, come and join us. And don't forget to bring your fare." He said, "Yes, of course." He was also in a amusing way departed with her, that whenever you feel like coming for bus ride, come and please don't forget to bring your fare, your charges. She laughed and jumped down from the bus. Then away she went, running straight for home. Then she jumped out and directly she started going to her home. When she entered her house, she found her mother awake and talking to one of Wali's aunt, the one from South Street. This aunt was a real chatterbox, never closing her mouth once she started talking. So she found that her mother was awakened, and one of her aunts were also there, and the habit of this aunt was she was very much talkative. And that is why she was given the name as Chatterbox, because once she started talking, she never stopped. "And where have you been?" said her aunt when Wali came. She spoke very casually, not expecting a reply. So Wali just smiled, and her mother and aunt went on with their conversation. So the aunt asked, and she did not answer. She only smiled, and she knew it, that aunt would not say anything. Mother and aunt started their conversation. "Yes, you are right," her mother said. "So many things in our minds and in the world outside. How can we possibly know about everything?" Aunt and mother started their conversation by saying that yes, there are many things happening outside the world, and it would be very difficult for us to know about each and everything. And even when we do know about something, we often can't understand it completely, can we?" "Oh yes," breathed Wali. Her mother said, "If we see, even though we are unable to understand each and everything," and Wali in between interrupted, "Yes." "What?" asked her mother. What's that you say?" Mother was not expecting that Wali would start speaking. She said, "What do you say?" "Oh," said Wali, "I was just agreeing with what you said about things happening without our knowledge." Wali said, "Yes, I agree with you that yes, many things are happening in the world without our knowledge." "Just a chit of a girl she is," said her aunt. "And yet look how she pokes her nose into our conversation, just as though she were a grown-up lady." Now the aunt said, "See, look at your daughter. She is interfering in our conversation. Though she was such a small girl, but she was behaving as if she was a grown-up lady." Wali smiled to herself. She didn't want them to understand her smile. But then, there was not much chance of that, was there? Wali smiled. And she did not want that they should understand the reason of her smile. She was smiling that many things are happening in her mother's life, that her daughter had gone and had a ride of city. But she did not know. But of course, Wali did not want anybody should know about her ride, anything. She smiled only. So dear children, I hope everybody followed it. Thank you.